time is at hand, is it not? If you are wise, you know the way into the chamber beyond. What is there? I cannot know, but perhaps you do. For you are beyond what you were. Beyond what I dreamt of. Yes. Surely more than a simple soldier. Surely more than a simple soldier. I pray you have come prepared. That you have listened to the words of the prophet. Five to find. Three are one. One gives access. The bladed sun. One gives access. The silver orb to banish below. The staff of ages to vanquish the foe. Joining to the golden sword. The last to invoke the platinum orb. The three pieces of the staff must be joined to make that which was unmade. But this cannot be done without an empowerment to bind them together. An empowerment not unlike the capturing of elementals. An empowerment that requires a great sacrifice. Now, let us be done with it.
Upon us, you have brought us to ruin. think not. You have done well, grandson. For the behemoth is neither good nor evil, but simply one who holds fast the fates of this world. Life, death, war, peace, sorrow, joy. These he disperses from the pit in careful measure. He has guarded these fates, and I, in turn, have guarded his power. Until now. This power I pass unto you, and bestow upon your brow a new name, Lord Jair of the Westland. Forsake it not, and wield it well, for in you the circle shall live on.
We'll be right back. For 40 years he has reigned. Jair, Lord of the Westland, the Seed of Prophecy. He who defeated Talamar the Black and kept the fates of the world secure in the Behemoth's grip. Or from within the pit, strife had escaped. Unchecked, it had moved throughout the Westland and its bordering ally, Cal Torlin. And it was there it sowed discord and discontent. And the eons-old lasting peace between the two nations? Not but a fool's dream. Within Cal Torlin's capital city of Gwenynthel, the change is evident. The vast port city has slowly shuttered its doors. Its great docks no longer host to the tall sails of ships from faraway lands. Its bustling streets, once replete with merchants and wayfarers, now empty. For it is here we find a small fenling, moving in plain sight as they often do. Like Lord Jair, he goes by many names, albeit all of his own choosing. Although, if you were unfortunate enough to brush against him, you might give him another. Thief. And so, in a dark Gwenynthel, the next tale begins. Not before a fabled door within the Gatekeeper Mountain, nor within the depths where prophecy was fulfilled and evil overcome, nor in a great hall where honors are given and received. Rather, begins here in the capital city when a Fenley is apprehended and delivered to the dungeons. Misunderstood pilferer, Del Cottonwood.